I'm doing the intro outside because this is like the best time for me to do an intro while I have a full face of makeup on, because I've been feeling unwell and I don't know how I'm gonna feel tomorrow, so I just thought let me do the intro now. So today we're gonna be doing a first ever baby DIY on this channel. Sorry, the sun is in my eyes. First baby DIY on this channel. I'm going to be doing a crib sign, and it's gonna be the sign that goes above a crib. So I'm gonna be doing one that I'll actually keep for my own child, which most of you know the name of my child will be Daisy. So I thought, why not my one say Oopsie Daisy on it? So I'm going to be doing it, and I'm gonna be telling you how to do it. It's gonna be a floral crib sign. You can do it for boys and girls, it doesn't matter. It's just really gorgeous. So grab your coffee, grab your tea, and let's do this baby DIY. Actually, scratch that. I was not meant to say crib. Sorry, that's what we call crib in London. The diaper station. So this is actually going to go above the diaper station. Hence why it's going to say oopsie, like mistake. Oopsie Daisy. You can put oopsie baby, but for my baby will be called Daisy. So I'm going to put oopsie Daisy, because you know how they say oopsie Daisy. Get it? So I'm going to be doing that. Sorry, I keep looking that way. People just keep staring at me. Weirdest place to do an intro, but I thought I'm going to just do it out here anyway. So you can do the oopsie whatever you want, or whatever you want to do, but I'm going to put this above the nursery changing station where you change diapers. So yes, let's do this video, dolls. My trusty Rust-Oleum metallic gold spray, and I absolutely love this spray because it's one of those golds that actually look gold, not like spray paint gold, if that makes any sense. Not all spray paints are really good, and I love this one because it literally gives it a metallic shiny finish, which is what you want. It makes it just look more expensive, and it looks silver here, but trust me, it's gold. There we go. It's because I've used it so much, and yeah, it's my perfect. I mean, I use it on every project if you've been watching my videos. So I'm going to be spray painting the edges of this, and make sure you don't do it outside, like near rain, because for some reason, just, I don't know if it's because of the humidity, but just, I just kept getting drops of water on my frame, and it kind of stayed in with the paint, which is not good, but you know, it's hard to tell from far, but I mean, it bothers me. So yeah, make sure you do it indoors, but not in like somewhere where there's no, I mean, find a good place to spray paint, basically. As long as people don't inhale this as well, be safe when you spray paint. And I'm using the Rust-Oleum. Definitely check this out, they have it in Home Depot, and that's where I got mine from. So make sure you give your spray to your frame two coats of spray paint, because it just makes it look more expensive, as I said, and just looks better. And be very, very careful in the first few hours of touching it, because your fingerprint could get in it. You have to be really, really careful when you spray paint, so it can look really done up really good. I mean, lots of times, especially with this particular paint, I will touch it and then my fingerprint gets stuck in it and I have to go over it again. And you don't want to overly spray it, because it's going to be clumpy and nasty and thick. So you want two thin layers of spray paint, and just leave it. Don't move it around for 24 hours, sometimes even a little bit more than 24 hours for it to really like stay good. We're all done and ready to dry, so take it in or whatever you have to. Be very careful handling it, and just don't touch it, let it sit to dry. And I just have mine outside up against the wall, and that's where I'm going to leave it overnight to dry, because you don't want to touch it again. Remember, fingerprints, that's going to ruin your whole project if you have a big thumbprint of yours inside the frame. So make sure you do that. Okay, so now I've taken my frame inside, I've removed the whole back, and basically what I did was cut out, I bought some foam board also from Michaels, and I believe it was $9, a huge foam board, and here it is, and I cut out the measurements from the back of the frame, and I just put it against here and traced it and cut it out with an X-Acto knife, and I did that all off camera. Using my trusty E6000 glue to attach the board to the frame. So now the frame is in, I'm going to make some holes with my knife. You can use anything sharp to do this, it doesn't have to be a knife, and as you can see I'm just going to twist it in circles just so I can catch the stem, so it can sit nicely inside there with some glue. It doesn't have to, you don't have to do this, but this just guarantees your stem is like rooted in the foam board. And that's what I did. I made so many holes, and it's just gonna catch my stem. My pink glue gun, which I got from Hobby Lobby, and I'm just going to be putting my glue stick inside and letting that get ready to attach flowers. I got all my flowers online, and let me tell you, dolls, they were not enough, and they are basically a set of 15 per color. So I got 15 each per each color, and I have this white creamy one, I have this light pink one. So you're about to see four colors. I have this like nudish kind of pink, blushy pink color. I'm not good with my descriptions, in a dark pink color. And as you can see, four of them, I got 15 of each, which was not enough. I had to go to Michaels and get more. So yeah, you're going to need a lot of flowers basically. So altogether, I spent a lot on the flowers. The flowers is really where everything costs. And this oopsie daisy, I got someone on AliExpress to make this for me and it broke. So I'm going to just attach that by glue just for this video. But once this video is done, I'm going to buy a new one and fun part. And so basically we're just going to put some glue in those holes and then put a bit around the stem, the bottom of the stem, also to just like really secure them. And I would say the wisest thing to do is start around this like perimeter, the edges of the frame. it kind of helps God, guide you where you want to kind of put flowers. And how I do my flowers is I do one color. So like a cream, a light pink, a cream, a nudish pink, a light pink, a dark pink, and just keep going in a pattern. And then sometimes break the pattern up and change it a bit, because you don't want it to be too matchy. You want it to look like how nature actually is and how flowers grow, which is totally random. There's no like planning of where each color would be. You want it as natural as possible, because how I want this frame to be is like a burst of flowers coming out of the frame, and that's exactly what I went for. So make it as natural looking as possible. If it's too like choreographed, if it's too like strategic, it's gonna look man-made. You want it to look as natural as possible, because these flowers actually really look real, like real roses, like seriously. So as you can see, I'm just like doing a pattern, but I'm making it random as possible. And you just want to keep going and going and going as random as you can, and bunch them up as close as possible, because you don't want the whiteboard underneath to show. The whiteboard is basically there to push for something to, first of all, attach the flowers to, but also push the flowers forward. That's why it has foam in it, to just push the flowers out so the flowers look like they're bursting out the frame or out of the wall when it's framed into the wall. So that's why it's there. So you don't want the white inside the, you don't want it to show, basically. And just keep going and make sure these are very close together. Okay, so I ran out of flowers, as I told you dolls earlier, so I had to go to Michael's. And luckily, Michael's were doing a deal. These are usually $10, but Michael's did 50% off all spring flowers. So I wanted daisies because, as I told you, my daughter will be called Daisy. And I just thought it would be perfect. I mean, we need daisies in there, right? So it makes sense, right? Daisy for daisies. I don't know. So I got at least three of them to be on the safe side. So I got two whites, so $5. This was $5. They're all $5, basically, half of 10. And a pink, just because I wanted pink in there. Just because, I mean, I asked you dolls on Instagram and you dolls said yes. So I decided to just last minute buy the pink. I just love it. I got the classic white and yellow daisies, and that's going to go in there. So I think I got three altogether, which was enough to make my flowers to be full. And I believe eight are on each one of them. There's about eight of them on there. Oh, I forgot to say, you had to cut all of them off. That was the most tedious thing and the most hardest thing to do. And I'd say definitely get someone to help you do them, because it does take a while to just cut all of them off. But, you know, I was not using the real thing to cut it, like pliers. I was using normal regular scissors. So I guess that's probably why it did take forever. But they're done and they're ready to go, and they just look so gorgeous, but not as gorgeous as the other flowers, because they look really real. They're like silk flowers. So we're just going to mix them up. So the night before, I got some flowers from Hobby Lobby to fill it up. So I won't be needing them. They're really huge, and I like it because it added texture, but we don't need them because I like the daisies. The other one was just too big and they just didn't fit it. They didn't fit the theme. The daisies just made it look so much more dainty and pretty and soft. And the texture of the daisies up against the roses are just so pretty. So I'm going to do that. And I love them. And I love how they're big and they just stand out in the middle. So I'm just going to stick them in and just... What I also did, most of these are not stuck down. So what I'm doing is I leave them there and then I move them and then I stick them down. So it kind of helps you. It makes it less harder if you put them on there not glued and just remove them every time you want to glue one down. That is a quick and easy way to do this. I swear it went by so fast. So if you're wondering like, where am I going to put everything? And it kind of helps you not waste flowers at the same time. Because if you're gluing them like close to each other, you're going to waste them because you're just going to keep trying to like save space. So this helps a lot. Now I'm going to tackle this side. I've done the other side and they're all stuck down. I'm going to tackle this big gap that's here. I moved the flowers off. Now most of them are stuck down on the other side. I'm just like working on this side. So as I said, it does help to put all the flowers on there not glued and just stick them in those holes, which the holes came in handy because you can stick them in there and they're not glued, but they're just in there for now. Like the holes hold the stem in place and holds the flower in place, so you can figure out where you want stuff. And I think that's the most easiest way to do this project. And it just goes by so quickly, especially when you have music in your ears and you're just chilling, you know, have some coffee by your side or something. It goes by so fast. It's a fun project, and it's such an expensive looking project at the end. It'll make a good baby shower gift for sure. Getting to the final part of this, and I'm just filling everything in. This can also be the tricky part, because you want to make sure everything comes off really good, and it's just, you have to be really careful, move things around a lot. I just love how everything turned out in the end. Again, you don't want like the same colors next to each other, like pinks shouldn't be next to each other. Have a white or the cream break it up, or a daisy would break it up. I love how the texture of the daisies and the pearls go together. They soften and balance each other out. I love it a lot. So as you can see, I put a white daisy, and then now I'm going to put like a white rose to break up these right there in the corner. Just breaking up this with a hot pink daisy right in this corner right here. So let's look at it outside. Oh my god, dolls, here it is. It's done. It came out beyond perfect. This is like the dream nursery decor that I want for my baby's room. And I'm going to cherish this. It's right now, as we talk, this is in my storage unit waiting. One of those things I'm going to put up aside for when I have kids and just pull it out. It's just wrapped up waiting. This is probably one of my best projects. I am in love with this dolls, like obsessed with this project. Like dolls, I've never had a DIY that made me tear up and want to cry. This just makes me want to do that, because it's beyond perfect. I don't even know where to begin. It's just so perfect. Like, it makes me want to cry. Like, the level of perfection about this. This will easily cost over $200 on Etsy. Oh my god, I can't take it. Oh. And literally, if you dolls know, I want to name my daughter Daisy Pearl, and it has pearls in it and daisies. I just can't, my soul can't bear. So dolls, if you enjoyed this video, give it a big fat thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, subscribe down below. Let me know what you love most about this video, and if you're going to be making one of these, let me know also. My heart is just about to explode. It cannot take the level of cuteness and daintiness and prettiness in this one project. This is easily one of my best DIYs ever. excluding the mirrored coffee table, if you take that out, this is probably one of my favorite DIYs because it's just so cute. I love it, doll. Share it. If you know someone who's expecting a baby, send them this video. And it's just, and if you're going to a baby shower, this is the best gift you could ever give anyone, especially if you know the baby's name. Thank you so much for watching, dolls. I just am I'm in emotions looking at this. Like, oh my god, this is, if this doesn't give you baby fever, I don't know what else will. Can't take it. It's too much. And it can be used for anything, not just babies. You can use it for yourself and put your name there. You know, it's just oh my god, love it. So I low-key cried right after this video. This just makes me super, super emotional. I don't know why. It's just so symbolic for just everything. And it's just so pretty. I just can't bear. So I just had to let you dolls know that this project made me cry. That's how much intense, you know, this is. So yeah, I am so embarrassed. Thank you so much for watching, dolls. Oh my god, bye. It's just gorgeous. My heart can't take it anymore. I think why it really makes me so emotional is because I guess the reality of looking at it is that one day I'm going to have a daughter that's going to look up at this while I'm changing diapers. And it's just so beautiful. It's such a beautiful sight. I don't want to get emotional on this channel. I've never been this emotional on my channel, but this project just brought out all the emotions. I don't know what it is. It's just so beautiful. I could cry. I wish you dolls could see my face. It's making me tear up. I know it sounds extreme, a DIY project made me tear up, but there you go. This is what it is being a woman, I guess. Everything makes you cry, but this one, this particular project is just making me tear up. And I guess because of the reality of what it's going to be for in the future is, you know, oh, I hope this project makes you dolls cry as it's making me cry. So thank you so much for watching this video, dolls. And as I said, give it a big fat thumbs up and get your handkerchiefs out to cry because it's so pretty.